traders, welcome to today's video at December 12th, Tuesday, right at about 7:30 Eastern PM. Sorry, 7:30 PM Eastern Standard Time. Okay, let's get into it. So today, let's take a look at data first. All right, the biggest data, of course, the most important one is the CPI year on year coming out from UK. And as I mentioned in my previous video, if we have anything above or below 3 will be an important impact because especially after seeing a bigger contest. Today we have 3.1%. Definitely means that inflation is still high. And not only that, this number actually came right after Bank of England raised interest rate already. So last time they raised interest rate and supposedly that's going to curb the inflation. However, that was not the case. We still had inflation tilting higher. And that means the Governor Carney had to write a letter to the Chancellor, basically explaining why the inflation is still high. But that also inject a lot of probability for the Bank of England to even become more hawkish on Thursday for the meeting. Or they might really have to raise interest rate again if this inflation data still keep going higher. PPI data from US was very positive, 0.4 as expected, but the core PPI is at 0.3, better than expected. So that's pretty much the two most important catalysts for the day. And the Draghi speak didn't really have anything, same as Lloyd speaks. However, I want to show you something very important and interesting is that regardless of the high inflation of UK and the British pound, pound still lose the momentum for the day. As you can see, British pound continue to drop versus dollar. And look at the dollar, of course, dollar DEX continue to edge higher. So let's take a look at the euro pound, because then that will be more accurate. Because a lot of time you look at a certain pair, might be the weakness of the one pair or might be the strength of the other pair. Okay, so it's always a better practice to look at these two pairs to see the real strength or weakness of the currency. Oh, the simple thing is you can just look at a currency index, right? So if you look at the British pound currency index, still edge lower. But personally, I like to look at different currency pair to see exactly how it performs. Okay, let's wait for this to come out. And okay, let's take a look at that. Let's put euro pound. So Europound also 4-hour chart, didn't really move that much, but I'll say, you know, euro is still well supported, at least in this short-term trend up right now. So British pound obviously lost strength today, regardless of high inflation. Why? You know, a lot of people ask it, even myself, actually, I lost a trade today because I was stupid, and I'll explain that later. The reason is because the pre-exit sentiment was simply too strong and too negative. Okay, the reason British pound right now is in the downtrend was because market, regardless of the deal that it reached with EU, market is really, really doubtful about whether UK can really reach a pre-exit deal. I know they passed the stage one, but you have to understand they have to take that proposal to the parliament. And the parliament is going to vote tomorrow to see whether the MPs have power to reject the pre-exit deal. You have the whole thing, why pre-exit deal had become so difficult, is not only because the negotiation between EU and UK, it's also because Theresa May does not have enough control, not only in the parliament, but also within her own party. She's really in a very delicate position right now. A lot of parliament members from the opposite parties, of course, want her to out. But most scary thing is within even her own party, she didn't even have enough support. A lot of conservative members want her out as well. So that's why there's a lot of roadblocks. Okay, there's a lot of things is going to stop her basically from doing what she can do. So that's why market that very, very doubtful about the pre-exit deal. And that sentiment had really become a strong sentiment pretty much for British pound right now. And I had mentioned about that yesterday. My game plan was that I want to sell pound if we have anything below 2.8, if we have anything below 3, between 2.8 to 3%, I will still want to sell pump, but I probably wait some retracement in 5-minute chart, things like that. For me to buy British pump, I need something above 3.2%. The reason is because the existing sentiment is already negative, it's already bearish. So for me, I only need a small trigger to continue the downtrend. On the contrary, I need a very big trigger, a big surprise to reverse the downtrend. So that was my plan. And guess what? I broke my own rule. So I took a pound yen long, which I shouldn't have taken. I took a pound yen long at 5-minute chart when 3.1% come out. And why did I do that? Very simple. I let my emotion got over with my logic. You know, and that's the thing about trading. No matter how long you've been trading, no matter how good you are, you always have this moment where your emotion get better out of yourself and you make a decision purely on the emotion side, not on the logical side. So that was my biggest mistake today. I took a trade. It doesn't matter what happened to the chart. It doesn't even matter if this trade is a winner or not. The things about trading is you have to have a good habit. All these things that we're trying to do to approach the market in a certain way and try to be consistent is because you want to be able to trade the market in a consistent way. Eventually, that's going to become your habit. And that habit will determine whether you're going to become a successful trader or not. Because if you trade the market randomly, a lot of people do that, you will have winnings for sure, right? It's a probability game. Of course, you're going to have wins and lose. But the scary thing is if your wins are from an inaccurate approach, I can guarantee you eventually you will go bust. You will lose in this game. So you have to go to a forex trading or any type of trading with a long-term perspective. Understand that you're in this game for a long term. A lot of people like to make a short-term cash. That is why if you look at Bitcoin, it's so popular this year, this month, or these few weeks. Because a lot of people who never even trade just want to make a quick gain, quick bet. And the fact is they might and they will. But I don't care about that because I know eventually they'll go bust. The thing is that you have to treat it like a more like a long-term career. Guys, even if you're doing it, just even if you just started, even if it's just something you might be interested in, it doesn't matter. You know, it's like picking up a new instrument. You want to put up enough time, effort, and most importantly, you want to practice it in a consistent manner in order for you to have at least have some skill set to, if you want to trade part-time, yeah, you want to also at least do it in a more semi-professionally instead of just doing randomly. So for me, biggest mistake for me is to get into this trade. It's not the way I got in. It's not about the resistance support. It's that I broke my own rules. For me, again, why is that happening? Because I should have gotten with a bigger surprise. And the reason is because we need a bigger surprise to turn around the existing sentiment. So that's the thing about trading. Always look at the market in a bigger context. Don't just jump in and look at individual data and say, oh, wow, 3.1%, that's great for pump. I'm going to buy it. Because you don't know what had been happened. What had been happened is that British pound had been sold off, and you have to ask yourself, why has it been sold off? What kind of sentiment was it? And is that sentiment going to last? And for me, the answers are all yes, so I should not enter it, and I did. Took a stupid loss today. Okay, so this is one of my losing trade. Now, of course, DAX right here is still very strong. But as I mentioned, this small strength might be just buy rumor, sell fact. So tomorrow the FOMC is coming. Now, as I mentioned last week, the real worry for me is that regardless of a tax cut, tax reform bill, Federal Reserve rate high expectation, we were never able to break above this high. So you know, realistically speaking, if you read the market news, it's daily by daily, people are saying that US dollar is doing very well. Is it? Because if you look at it in long-term perspective, we really haven't been able to break this high. This might just be the reversal, right? This might be a reversal for the uptrend, or this could be a beginning of the downtrend. really depend on where are we going right here. If we're going above 95 and break it, yes, that means the uptrend is confirmed. On the contrary, if we break below 92, 65, or 50, means we are actually reversing to the downside. Then the next one will be 91 here. So all this combined with the fundamentals, why are people buying US dollar? Because tomorrow the FOMC is coming and expectation is for them to raise interest rate from 1.25 to 1.5. On top of that, today the PPI data, core PPI, which is the data has something to do with the inflation, had come out higher than expected. But this sentiment, if I ask myself, how strong is this going to last? I think it's going to last until tomorrow. Then we will see what happened in the press conference. What are the plans for the Fed members? And are they going to be more hawkish, dovish, or neutral? So for me to determine the long-term perspective or long-term trend for US dollar is really dependent on what's happening tomorrow. Okay. So pound yen, obviously one of my bigger lose. Dollar CAD didn't really go anywhere. And honestly, if we get stop out or not, again, really depend on what's happening tomorrow. We might have another round of buying rumor between now until the next New York session. That means between now, Asian session, London, New York, we might really go up to at least taste this resistance. There's going to be a lot of stop here, right? This is a very obvious resistance area. So a lot of stops will be here. That means there were a lot of stop hunting. A lot of people were trying to push this trade up to this level to trigger the stop orders. So that if that happened, I wouldn't be surprised. This trade for me is already a loser, right? It's so close to my low, so there's no point for me to adjust anything. I'll just let the market play out. LCK, on the other hand, still, for me, to look at a bigger perspective, it's still a range bound. I wouldn't worry or do anything about it as long as we are still within 38% to 68%. New Zcat, pretty much a losing trade for me as well. Now this one, you know, if I have to find a lesson for this trade, I would say that probably I should maybe go with a higher degree. You know, it's all depend on how you look at the market, right? I got in before and when the sentiment was favorable for Canadian dollar. And that's why you see this was a 50%. We have a big retracement. So this really, I gotta say, the only thing is perhaps I did not know that RBNZ is going to appoint the new government this week. So for me, the biggest mistake for New Z was the information, the lack of information. I did not know that there is going to be a new government. I know there's going to be a new governor for RBNZ. I don't know they are going to appoint the person this week. So this was a surprise for me. So that's why this trade is almost a loser. It's probably going to lose. If we don't lose this trade, that will be that would just be a technical issue, because my stop loss, I always put my stop loss at like 10 pips higher. So we might still be in this trade. This, you know, we do have this kind of inverse hammer, so this is a bearish signal. So this might just be a high. We don't know. I'm never trading like this kind of detail microscope. So for me, I don't really care, right? But for me, this consideration is just a losing trade, and it became a losing trade on the moment that I realized I missed out the information, very big information, that RBNZ was going to appoint a new governor this week. New Zealand, because of that, also not looking too well. You know, this one, 50% did not hold, and we keep aging higher. Now, I'm less concerned about this one, just because the reason behind this trade was trying to buy Japanese yen in December, because the expectation that we might have more risk of sentiment. So this is just a pure thing. You know, that's the reason to get in. So we will play alongside with that and see how it goes. Dollar yen is still quite relatively good, supportive. We are still haven't able to break above this high. So really depend on what happened to tomorrow's meeting. If tomorrow is a hawkish Federal Reserve meeting, I would expect us to pretty much reach 115. On the other hand, if it's a dovish one, we might taste 110 again. So it's big range. So it really depends on what happened tomorrow. Cable I did get out yesterday. Took the chance to get out. Now, of course, that doesn't mean I don't think cable is going down. I actually think cable is going to go down, but I won't wait for the FOMC meeting to pass first and to have this, I have a better understanding and clear direction for US dollar. Then I will re-enter this one. But because of the higher inflation and because the Thursday BOE is also going to come out, and on top of that, pre-exit, the parliament is going to vote tomorrow, I think, to whether the MPs have power to basically reject the pre-exit deal. So there's going to be another geopolitical sentiment tomorrow or this week. So I might just stay out. You know, for me, that's the safest way, maybe to stay out unless. So the only thing I will get into this trade is because tomorrow the FOMC is very hawkish, means I need a very strong US dollar to get into a cable short again. Okay, the euro dollar would be another good choice. Tomorrow, we'll see what happened. You know, you can look at chart really in any direction you like, and that's why it's best for you to combine with the fundamentals, because you can look at this chart and say, hey, this is just a retracement. This is just a retracement. So that means euro dollar is going to upside. Or you can look at this, say, okay, this is actually a downtrend. Means euro dollar is going to go down. Now, which one is right? They both are right. It really depends on how you look at it, which point you look at, or even what time frame you look at it. So for me, I don't use technical to determine the direction of a trade, right? I usually look at a bigger micro picture to determine the direction. So for me, where is euro dollar gonna go? I don't know. Depend on what happened to the FOMC press conference tomorrow. Then I will have a clear direction. For me, this is only trigger. I don't care what happened to euro, because euro is so quiet and so neutral. Nothing much is going to happen to euro, even in an ECB. Of course, I might be wrong. ECB might suddenly become hawkish and dovish, but according to what had happened previously with Draghi and his conservative approach, I don't think ECB is going to give any sort of surprise or any sort of long and lasting surprise. On the contrary, I'm more interested for the US dollar's press conference. So all in all, the best way to trade euro dollar, or the best timing, is really maybe wait after Wednesday and Thursday. And a lot of people say, what about, you know, all this momentum? Maybe you want to jump in, bank on that. You could, but for me, I'm honestly really clueless. I don't know what's going to happen. So for me, the only way to trade into a catalyst is if you have a very strong conviction in a certain direction. Okay, so back then, for example, back then I bought euro dollar all the way from June until September in 3 months period, because I knew a strong conviction was for euro to go to the upside, regardless of what ECB is saying. The reason is because the market knows that the fundamental data from euro had been very well. The inflation had been picked up. So even though the ECB member is trying to put down the market expectation, the reason is because they don't want a euro to go up too high. That would jeopardize the whole plan of the monetary policy, right? That would jeopardize the whole plan for loosen monetary policy. So they were trying to keep maybe having a more dovish talk, and the reason, and that's why you have all these occasionally downtrend, but markets simply did not buy into it. They don't believe it, they don't care. They look at the data, they think ECB is going to cut the stimulus package. So that's why it was a continuation of uptrend. So that's where you can trade into a catalyst, is when you know no matter what the Federal Reserve or no matter what the central bankers say, or no matter what the data come out, the currency is going to go certain direction. And actually, same thing happened today for cable, right? And that's again one of my stupid mistakes, because we already knew that British pound had a negative sentiment from pre-exit or a pre-exit negotiation, and we already knew the market is selling it after last Friday because buy rumor sell fact, and already knew that this sentiment is going to continue. So the only thing that's going to change it is if we have a higher CPI data, higher than 3.2. Otherwise, no matter what the shortened spike is, British pound should still go to the downside. And if you look at that, that's actually the correct way, which I did look at it, but I did not follow. Okay, if you look at that, you actually will sell at this high. You actually would sell today on top of the higher inflation. You're actually saying, okay, that's a great chance for me to take advantage and sell it at the high. Nevertheless, you know, no matter how accurate your analysis is, when you want to execute it, that's a completely different story. And that's one thing to remember, that trading and analysis are completely two different things. That's why you have a lot of people who are very good at analysis, who are just very sounding economic analysis or technical analysis. You know, they are great at telling people what's going to happen to the market, but they are not that good at trading. And the biggest issue is because the execution is all about your trading emotion and psychology. So that is something you have to really understand and try to get better at it. And the only way to get better at it is by trading, right? Because you have to trade every day, trade often, then you realize what kind of psychological issue you have, what kind of roadblocks that stop you to execute your trade. Okay, so guys, that's a quick review for my current trade and what had been happening today. Tomorrow, pretty much, I think in the morning will be very, very quiet, regardless of the CPI data. You know, this, although it's very important, because of the FOMC, I think the market will generally speaking very, very flat all the way until the FOMC meeting. Now, we do have the UK labor market. Honestly, I don't think it's going to provide too much volatility. It might give you a shortened volatility, but not too much. So if you're a scalper, yeah, you can do it. But for me, really, the big driver will come in the afternoon. Okay? All right, guys, that's it. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know. Other than that, I'll be back tomorrow. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.